Hello there, everybody. Welcome back for some more Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories. And now we're still in Atlantica, of course. Now we're going to go ahead and finish it off. So let's head down this way. And then I think we take a right or... Yeah, right on my side, but left on the box side. So I guess we're going to take a left to get to the other side. So we can head into the Key to Truth door. So, easy enough. More guarded troves, of course. I don't feel like fighting any Heartless because screw that. I think I'm done. Of course, I never got a chance to show off Ariel's abilities, but more than likely, once we get to fight Ursula, that's probably when they're going to go ahead and let us do it. So let's finish off this world and get into the next and basically last world we're going to have. So let's do a one equal, and then of course, Key to Truth. We already used the Key to Rewards card, so we got some good stuff out of that. Fortunately, we didn't get any other cards to use in other worlds, like more Key to Rewards cards. So, that's unfortunate. Okay, so this is the Ursula fight. Now, basically, what you have to do is pretty much knock her tentacles off of the platform here. She has some pretty low cards. By that, I mean, like, she has some pretty basic cards, if anything. You will eventually get... There is a Mickey card, of course, for this boss fight particularly. So, don't fret on that. Oh, come on. Just stop, you fucking bitch. God damn. Yep, she keeps breaking my cards. I'm getting really pissed off now. Okay, so let's pop in a nice four. And once you knock down her tentacles, basically she's going to start coming towards you. Now you can pretty much start doing some damage to her. I guess she does have some higher cards than six. Huh, I was thinking she has sixes. Nope, she's got quite a bit of strong cards here. Fortunately for us, we have quite a bit of... We're getting a lot of friend cards too, which is nice, but I could use probably something better than that. I'm trying to think. I want to pop one of hers. Yeah, if I just break with a zero. That way she can't do anything with it. Alright, let's fuck her up. I think that she might be resistant to lightning. Maybe, or at least probably, you know, absorb it. Which, that's what I was kind of afraid of. Are you serious? She actually broke that. Wow. That's a scary thought. She's probably going to break this. She has zeros. I mean, it's... Well, not zeros, but she has eights. I'm sure she can. Okay, well, fuck it then. Fine. Well, I guess we'll have to do this then. This is a pain in the ass fight, just because she can break so many cards of mine, and it's really getting on my nerves. Of course, if I would actually use Jafar, I could probably use that to my advantage, and make it to where she can't break my cards. She's gonna kill me, I know she is. Alright, let's do this then. Might have to just go ahead and use Lethal Frame. Yep, that way I can just stop this kind of crap from happening. There we go. Okay, sweet. And bada bing, bada boom. Yeah, you know, I actually forgot about using, it's arrow, ice, and then I think it's magic. Yeah, for homing Blizzara. That could be useful. But I want to go ahead and just use it on her instead of just... Oh, damn. That one didn't do very much damage, but I like how it does that. That's actually a pretty cool thing there. Alright, let's go ahead and show off what Ariel can do. Which is, if I remember correctly, not much. She does what she does in the original game, of course, where she just... kind of spins towards enemies. She was good in the original game. It's just now Since I wasn't attacking a tentacle, of course, that's kind of what screwed me over. You know, the thing is, where the hell are the Mickey cards? Like, I thought we were supposed to get some Mickey cards out of this. Oh, there it is, finally. Jesus Christ. Like, seriously, like, you know, just pop one in, like, please. There we go. So you basically make her choke and kind of knock her on her fat ass there. Oddly enough, I didn't really get Donald out of that. That's weird. So now, when she's knocked down like that, you can start doing some nice bit of damage. So it's basically just a free attack, practically. Let's see here. I don't have arrow anymore, because I used it up because I had to. Oh, this sucks dick so much. Wait, I never even used it, did I? Oh, wow. Oh, there you go. I guess now it takes care of that, so I think we're kind of running out of cures here, which is unfortunate. Yep, she's one of those kinds of villains where it's just like... She's one of those kinds of boss fights that's just pain in the dick to get through. Just because of, you know, all this crap that's going on field at one time. Okay, let's pop one in real quick. Real fast. Let's just get rid of her already, just so we can stop her from doing that. Alrighty, there we go. Yeah, I don't really like her fight that much just because of the tentacle thing. Like, you have to go through those first to take her down, which is annoying. Until, of course, you get, like, you know, a card that is, of course, you know, a Mickey card. But even then, that barely even seems to come out when I want it to, of course. And I'm running out of attack cards, unfortunately. No, I'm doing pretty good, it seems like. Okay, well, there we go. We got another Mickey card. Let's break her down and kill her that way. That seems to be the way they want you to do it, but unfortunately, I got screwed over a lot, so... That happens. And she is done. Takes care of Lanica. Next up is Hollow Bastion. Hopefully we level up from that. That would actually be pretty nice, because I don't think we leveled up for a while. We did level up in this world, of course, but I think it's been quite a while since I have, so... Let me see something here. Looks like... I wasn't even paying attention. So now I got her card, and we'll find out if I leveled up or not. Because, probably not. Of course not. Why would I? Okay, let's see what Ursula's card does real fast. It does half the damage of enemy's magic attacks. Okay, you only take 5 hits from it, and then it breaks. So, card. I wouldn't say the best card, but more of just, I probably wouldn't use it. I barely use any of these cards anyway. Honestly, Dimex would be a useful card in terms of like using Homing Blazara, but even then, it just, I wouldn't really worry about putting on. Thing is, I'm going to be honest, I hate Ariel, just as a character. Like, she's so stupid, you know? Like, it's one of those, like, she just does something so stupid, and then she gets in trouble for it. And, of course, you know, she thought about lying, of course, no surprise. But, I mean, yeah, Sora brought it up, of course, too, but I'm sure she probably thought of it, more than likely. So, there's that. Atlantica is now finished and on to Hollow Bastion.
Guess he must have finally got tired of fighting with you.
I sure hope so.
That's it, really? I thought we had to find somebody. What the hell? Maybe Riku doesn't want to fight with you anymore. Hopefully not. Careful, you never know where Riku might be hiding. Yeah, he's probably hiding in the darkness. You know what I'm saying? I'm just kidding. Alright, I'll stop.
So what's going on, Vexen? Your Riku was supposed to counter Sora. What's he waiting for? Where is he?
He's hiding somewhere to lure Sora deeper into the castle, right? I suppose we should just leave it at that, you know.
Aha! Oh, I see now. I would have never guessed that. So sorry, Vexen.
Silence!
Predictable response. Forget it. Men without hearts are so boring.
You're one to talk. As if you have such a heart to speak of yourself.
That's enough.
Marluxia!
Vexen, the simple fact is that your project was a failure. You'd best not disappoint us again.
Disappoint you? You go too far! In this organization, you're number 11. I'm number 4 and I will not have you!
I've been entrusted this castle and nominee by our leader. Defying me will be seen as treason against the organization.
Traitors are eliminated. I believe that's what the rules say.
Who needs a half-baked good-for-nothing anyway?
Vexen, you cannot win against Sora.
Pity to be so ignorant. As you're only able to see the surface of things, I should not expect you to appreciate my true might.
Oh? Then let us watch as you prove it.
What?
None of us wish to be suspicious of a comrade.
Your insincerity is comforting.
You give a challenge like that to Vexen and he'll seriously want to eliminate Sora.
That would be an unfortunate denouement. What to do? Your hero is soon to be wiped from existence. But I believe there is a certain promise that he made you. Isn't that right, Namine?
Yes.
Wow, the tenth floor! We've gotten up pretty high!
And that must mean we've lost 10 whole floors worth of our memories. Sora, it's still not too late. Don't you think we should turn back?
Can't do it. Because that would break an old promise that I made.
An old promise? What would that be?
On the islands, I promised Namine that I'd keep her safe, no matter what. But I forgot it. I didn't remember until I started forgetting everything else. A promise between the two of us. That's why I can't leave. Now that I remember the promise, I have to keep it.
Of course. We understand, Sora.
Okie dokie, let's see what the boys have to say now. If you remember your promise to Namine, then you must have your important memories, or still must. Special promises like yours are meant to be kept. Alright, so. Now that being said, we have the last world of this next tier of cards, I guess, to go through, which is going to be, of course, Hollow Bastion. And this is where Beast will be, so if anybody was wondering about that, well, there you go, now you know. Now, after this, we're on the 10th floor right now. So, we have 11, 12, and 13 left to go. If I'm correct, if I think there's 13, there should be. Okay, never mind, I was thinking of something stupid. I think I know what the 13th is.
Thank you.
Okay, now remember, folks, this is still Chain of Memories, but it also has some key aspects of Kingdom Hearts 1 in it, meaning that those whole lightning rod things are still in effect. I mean, of course, we don't have to do, you know, traverse this whole entire thing like a maze, unless you consider, of course, the entire game basically being a maze, but, you know, hey, it's not too bad, I would say. So, alright, let's do lethal frame on these guys real quick, take out these guys. We got wizards to take care of now, too. That's another new kind of enemy. Oh, and of course, defenders. Oddly enough, probably one of my personal favorite of Heartless. I don't know, I like them a lot. Now, wizards, I think, can take... Well, what their key aspect is they can basically absorb any kind of magic attack. Of course, meaning, you know, lightning, I think they... lightning, fire... Well, thunder, I should say. Fire, blizzard. Now, not only that, but I think they can't... I think they can still take damage to arrow. I think arrow might be one of those ones that they actually do take damage from. I want to go ahead and check that out real fast. I'll see what happens if I do it. Yeah, they still take damage from arrow, but I think they recover from ice, as you can see. And I'll do lightning real quick to show that off. There you go. Don't do any of those. Lightning, fire, and ice attacks. Don't do any of those. Of course, Donald uses lightning because fuck him, why not? But that's what Donald does best. Now, their cards, these guys, you know, the wizards, their particular cards are not too strong anyway, so we'll be fine with that. We can basically wipe them out. Defenders, I think, have some pretty decent amount of cards, too. Wyverns, I think, are going to be the ones that are going to give us a problem. Defenders are basically kind of like large bodies where they are protected from the front, but they're not going to be too much of a problem to take care of. Of course, we can always get behind them and wipe them out that way. Alright, so... Oh, okay, I just got shocked off. And I'm confused as well. So that's another thing about Hollow Bastion's world that does really piss me off, is you get confused yourself, which does suck. And a confusion, I think, is also a slight. But I think we have one, actually. I think we do have confusion. Just don't remember how to do it, though. Because I never really pay attention to those. I just let them go. If I don't have the abilities... I'm just like, screw it, you know, whatever, it's no big deal. God damn, I need more attack cards. Well, thing is, I do actually have plenty of attack cards, really. Dude, I'm starting to like this homing Blizzaga, though. It's easy to remember. You know what I should do? I should actually put on regular potion again, just because. Because it seems to me like that seems to be the only thing to really kind of help me out here. Oh, they're also... I think you can also use... Well, more than likely, I assume so. You can pretty much use stop on them. I don't see why, you know, the game would make it to where you can't do that. That was on complete accident. I was trying to do something with it, but I ended up messing it up. Alright, yeah, after this fight, let's go ahead and switch up my card deck here. Let's get some more attack cards going and just... ooh, false bounty. I could use more of those. I want to not grind, but I also kind of want to grind as well. Ah, Christ. Yeah, if you hit that, it will stun. Or it will confuse other enemies too, so that's good. Let's see here. Any high, really high cards? We got an 8 that we can throw in there as well, so let's do that. Oh, Christ. never mind with that one. Maybe. Let's take out the Mega Potion and throw in on just a regular high potion, or just a regular potion. 45. That's plenty. Yeah, that's still plenty. Okay, I'd rather have a high 6 than a low 4 that I have to, you know, combine with. That would, in my opinion, just get kind of annoying. Luckily for me, confusion in this game is like with most games, where they don't control, like, it's just for the controls, it's not for the, well, just for the analog stick, it doesn't mess with the button layout or anything like that. Most games do, well, I should say a lot of games, not most games, a lot of games also do, we actually got wizard card, oh, nice. They also like to do the whole thing where you get your buttons completely changed and mapped, but this one just inverts the controls, which is not too harsh. Really, it's not. Especially since it's a chain of memory, it's like, why even bother with going, you know, all the way? It just wouldn't make any sense, really, to be like, you know, fuck it. We're not going all the way with all this stuff anyway, so what's it really matter, right? Alright, so wizards are going to be a little tougher to hit from the ground, unfortunately. Now, luckily for me, dark balls, I believe, are pretty easy to hit from the ground, so that's good. Or at least close to the ground. Hollow Bastion is not a bad world by any means, it's just, it's one of those kinds of worlds where it's just... Oh, they have sixes. Oh, fuck me, then. Alright, well, that sucks. Of course you do. Yeah, so wizards do have sixes, but I don't think they have anything higher than six. That's good. Defenders, oddly enough, have some pretty low cards as well, but I mean, it kind of, I guess it kind of differs too. Like, sometimes they throw out twos. Like, that one right there, that one threw out like a four, which is odd. Thing about them, though, is you can stun lock them from behind. So, that's always kind of helpful. And shock his ass. I'm going to heal up real fast. Throw one of these bad boys. I'm going to break him down, and there we go. Yeah, arrow can basically, arrow has some kind of piercing damage to it, too. Meaning, of course, it can go right through shields. Which is pretty much, you know, large bodies or defenders. Like, frontal ends. So that always does kind of help out. These are wyverns, I think. Well, this one's red. Usually wyverns are blue. These ones suck because you have to chase them around the map to be able to kill them. They like to, you know, fight around a lot. They look like sharks. They're pretty cool looking enemies, really. A little scary looking, too, because I have a distinct fear of sharks, pretty much. So, of course, in my mind, it's like, oh, fuck that. You know, I don't want to touch anything like that. Hell no. Okay, is that it? Nope, still one more Heartless to go. I think this might be the last Heartless of this room particularly. Hopefully it is. Alrighty. So yeah, just get behind a defender and you can easily fuck him up like so. Again, really easy to do so. I wish that whenever you do Strike Raid or stun an enemy, they'd be stunned for the certain, a certain amount of duration. Like, I mean, because as soon as you hit somebody, that's when the stun goes away. I wish it would actually still last. But that also kind of goes into me, too. It's like, if that was the case, it would also probably have to do the same thing to me. You know what I mean? You have to have that pro versus con kind of thing going on, too. Oh, come on! More wyverns? Are you serious? It does piss me off that they do fly around like that a lot. It's really it really is obnoxious. But that's how wyverns do work. They just fly around and they're just obnoxious. Alrighty, let's see here. Fuck you. Yeah, but at least you can pretty much stun lock them. That's not what I asked for. I asked for this. I wish I could just jump in air and just throw it. No, it has to be on the ground. Like, even if I do, command it in midair, I'm gonna fall to the ground anyway, so it kind of breaks that down. So that, I wonder what that changed. Oh, it changed that platform. Okay. Yeah, basically now I can start using the platform. Alright, let's see here. What would lead me into something good? That would lead me into the treasure room, so I guess I'd be a dead end, so I can use that right now. Yeah, I can get this one out of the way right now, just to kind of have the dead end room out of the way. A wanderer up. That is always good for me, because I would take a calm bounty anytime, any day. The good thing is, since Atlantica kind of fucked me over when it came to, like, enemy spawns, or how strong they were, but of course that was kind of my fault too, because if you think about it, you know, I was the one that pretty much made them spawn that way. If it wasn't for me doing that, or, you know, using the trove, nothing bad would have happened. Alright, let's see here. Oh, also the chests look pretty new too. Reflect Raid. So Cloud, Attack, and Attack. I wonder what that would look like. We can equip it real fast and find out. Yeah, let's do that. I'd have to rechange it back, of course, but what could I change out for it? I could change out my stop. I could change out the Ice one, just put in a nice Cloud card. Just for now. Yeah, but that over-limits it, so... could take out the Aether. Yeah, for now. Alright, let's go fight somebody real fast, and then I'll show that off. If there would be any Heartless that would spawn, of course. Probably not. I could make them spawn. I could do, like, a sleeping Heartless room and just keep going with Calm Bounty. And then... Or maybe just, like, a Guarded Trove real fast. Yeah, that could work. I could probably use a Guarded Trove if anything. Okay, so we got some decent cards. We don't really need that much. That is good. That is good. I like that. I really like that. I like how this world has decent enough cards. Now, I think this world particularly has the 33 set of key rewards. It's like 33 green, red, blue, all that. If I'm not mistaken. Okay, so we got arrow. We got these guys. These guys are our new enemies. I forget what they're called. But I don't think they're new. I think we fought these guys before. Pretty sure we did. Alright, so let's go ahead and whip out Cloud. So it's Cloud and then two attack cards. Reflect Raid. Alrighty, that's not too bad. That's actually pretty cool looking. I'm sure it can probably do a lot of damage to just one person. Like, it did waste, like, most of these guys. I spit on my mic for a second there. That wasn't good. It did actually waste a lot of those guys. So that's a really decent card set, but... I don't really find it good for, I guess, groups. Because it seemed to have, like, a really small AoE to it. Like, a very close-up AoE, of course. All right, fuck you, and bam, there we go. All right, so the strongest enemies here are probably wyverns, if anything. Because, like, we're not having to deal with any aqua tanks, which is nice. Yes, just get down there. Christ. Alrighty, let's see here. What can I equip instead? Could do another stop, just because, you know, could always go for another lethal frame. Yeah, I mean, I don't see why not. You know, two of them would be pretty good to have. But I also want, that's one of those retard-ass ones. I do want more attack cards, though. But, yeah, I could use more attack. That would be pretty good. I could do another one, maybe. Well, it's like 30, so that would overlay me by a lot. Alrighty, we don't have much time, so I want to use as much time as I can now. While I got the chance to go get the treasure chest. And or just run back and save and just come back in this room and just finish off the chest that way. Or grab the chest real fast. You know, get rid of these guys real fast. Go grab the chest. And then from there, go back to the save. That would be probably useful. Yeah, I think so. I think that'd be a good idea. If anything. Alrighty, and you gotta go, Mr. Guy. Alright, just die, please. Come on. I would like to use another arrow to show that off, but I don't know. I guess I can do two stops for now. Alrighty, let's see here. Let's grab this real fast. Let's not fuck with the Heartless right now, because we're gonna end up... We're gonna have to come back in this room anyway. I mean, if you think about it, because it's the only way to get in the... Oh, come on! It's the only way to get in the next area anyway, so yeah. Kind of screwed on that one, guys. Sonic Blade, let's fuck these guys up. I think it's like whenever they're like on the ground, that's when you can actually do Sonic Blade. Oh, wow, did you see that? Actually, it's going pretty well there. Woo! Stun Impact does return from the original game. Most of these actually do return from the original game. It was actually pretty good there, too, I think. Oh, come on, I didn't mean to do that. I didn't mean to do that either, but I did on accident. I'm trying to like go through these attack cards. Like, the cards are in the way, so it's like, I want to use them as attack cards, you know? But I know I can't, like, it'd be just a waste of time. Okay, I'm gonna take out the Wyvern first, just because of what they do. Just because they fly around all the time, they're just really obnoxious enemies to deal with. Alright, we got a nice set of Goofy, so Goofy Tornado 3, which is gonna completely dominate the shadows. The good thing is, at least his targeting is ridiculous, and like, that's ridiculously fast too, by the way. Let's pop one of these, and then pop one of these. So another Goofy Tornado, which won't last very long, but hey, you know, that's plenty of time for me to go ahead and heal up and then reload a card and then waste this guy. So, done. There we go. And looks like I might have got a key to rewards. That's not too bad. That's not too bad. I guess what you could do necessarily is come to these later worlds and just grind up for key to rewards. Because I did get two in Neverland, if you remember correctly. So, by doing that, you can always just probably just head back and just, you know, do all that stuff. So, Divine Rose is the key blade here. Rumbling Rose is in them too, which is a badass key blade, though. But, as it stands right now, it's a two, so it's not really going to help me much. I think it has more power than anything else. Like, it has some pretty thrusting and all that. But from what I understand, I think it's actually probably like maybe a C or B card? Maybe, hopefully, possibly. Let's go find out. Alright, well, if you guys want to go ahead and leave now, you totally can. But I'm going to go ahead and do the reading stuff for these people. So let's get Atlantica out of the way. So here's Ariel, of course. She looks just as dumb as she always does. And you guys can pause, you know, whenever I start to scroll down. So if you want to see those. Here's Sebastian, of course. I love these when I don't have to scroll down because it saves me some time. I don't know why they put those in like two different paragraphs, but that's usually what they do. Alright, and then of course here's Ursula. So that's the last of those. So Flounder and Ursula, and then we're done with those. Got some new Heartless. Defenders, Wyverns. So here's Defenders. Like I said, they're one of my favorites. I do love the music of Hollow Bastion. I like Hollow Bastion as a world. It's just, you know, in the original game, it was one of those, like, you know, annoying-ass worlds to go through because... Just all that's... Hold on, wait. We're almost done. We got one more. That's one more boss there. Got two more there. So, we got two more enemies to find. Which I'm trying to think of who that would be. Huh. There's no secret Heartless, really. Ah, Strike is A. Thrust is D+. Combo Finish is C. Physical, of course. Recovery is C. And B for CP. Obtain the Hollow Bastion. Delivers powerful strikes, but slow to recover from card breaks. That's why you want a really high card, because at least then you can do some major damage, but then, of course, you know, not to worry about that. Aerial whirls across the field, striking many enemies, stuck more than one for multiple strikes. What do you mean you don't have to? You have to worry about what is it called? Getting knocked back. You have to worry about that, but your power is great. So wizards give you a magic boost. Disables use of summon cards to power up magic cards. Oh, okay. Limit one reload. That's it. That sounds like a shitty card to me. Ursula, we've seen that one before. Don't know why that's there. Well, I guess I read it inside of the whole thing. So here's Sora's tale. I'm gonna go ahead and start scrolling down so you guys can pause on that paragraph. And you guys can pause on this one real quick, and then I will scroll down. And there we go. That's it for Sora's Tale number 3. We got one more to go, and then we have Atlantica done. So here's Atlantica's descriptions. I'm gonna go ahead and scroll down. I know there's like a shark up there too on the side there. Yeah, it's kind of terrifying. And then that's gonna be it for that. And then that will be it for Atlantica. So there we go. Obviously, Hollow Bastion is one of them. I assume that Oblivion and, you know, the other floors would be one too. So, yeah, that's it for that. I'm going to go ahead and save the game, and I'll see you guys next time when we play some more Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories. And as always, take care, everybody.